welcome to another presentation of Olga. She's going to be talking about Youth AI Challenge, very interesting concept that these guys are now launching. So please welcome Olga to the floor. Mic is yours.
Optimize our ourselves, optimize our science, our technology, and help us become better humans. So it's a useful technology. The challenge started a month ago, and we had this $5 million prize that I mentioned. So you can see that the first round has total amount of $50,000 in prize money. So it's going to be many rounds with probably different complexity. Some of the rounds will have bigger prizes and so on. We have a very nice lineup of partners from all around the world that are supporting the challenge. And the main organizer is Cool AI core team. So we have already introduced. Cool AI basically started in 2014 as this dream project of our CEO, Alvaro Maricosa, who first made the money in video games and then reinvested them into his own company that is developing general artificial intelligence. So our mission is to develop general AI with the help of our sister company. We are also starting to test our technologies on the market. And the team is about 20 researchers right now, most of them based in Prague, but recently also new additions in Bratislava. And here you can see the challenge team also. And our advisory board for the challenge. We're very happy actually that this got a very positive response in the AI community. So we are cooperating with different researchers on this who also helped us creating the tasks for the challenge or advise us how to approach the challenge better. And the first round of the challenge that started on February 15th is using an environment, a traditional environment that my colleague Sandin will introduce also in the tasks as well, that was developed by Facebook AI team. So we have some nice information there too. And strong support from community, you probably know Simon Šisko, who's the CEO of Pixel Federation based here in Bratislava. More. Can you hear me? Okay. Jiřina Terna, who started the machine learning conference in Prague. I think it's one of the biggest in Prague, in Prague combined with Bratislava, let's say, in terms of artificial intelligence. So it's going to be in April, and you're very welcome also to come there. So the challenge, how is it going to happen? Right now we start with the first round, as I mentioned, and this first round is dealing with the problem of gradual learning. So what is gradual learning? Basically, in short, someone will talk more about this, but this is about what I described already. It's about finding an AI algorithm which learns in a similar way as we humans do. So learns gradually, first learning some things, then building on top of them, reusing previously learned skills. And actually this way, finding better strategies of how to learn better. So an example could be, you would first learn a language, and then you would learn to read. And with this ability, you are able to read books, you are able to learn or teach yourself mathematics, you are able to teach yourself neuroscience, many, many different things. So you found a learning strategy which helps you in future learning. So that's the idea that we want to convey with this gradual learning round. Of course, the task will be a little bit more simple for the AI agent that you will be developing than learning mathematics or learning neuroscience. We will get to that. And there will be more rounds. Some of them will run parallel. This first round will run for 5 months. Then people can submit their, participants can submit their AI agents, their solutions. And also we want to introduce different topics, not just programming AI, but also dealing with theoretical problems as AI safety, different aspects of AI safety, or road mapping different futuristic visions, and actually assessing what kind of different paths our future could take, and trying to come up with the best recipe how to get to the desired future. Oh, sorry. Wrong way. So now it's time for me to pass the word to my colleague, who's one of the senior research scientists in Good AI, Sanbin. So he will tell you more about the challenge. First round of the challenge and the task that we actually have in this first round of our field. So, thank you.
Thank still learning. So like, why do you do this kind of stuff? So like, put out money for people to do it. Okay, so imagine we want to make some super intelligent AI fairly quickly. Which one would be faster? There's two methods. Assuming that there could be one method, but assuming there's only two methods. One, we do some superhuman vision, superhuman language understanding, superhuman memory, superhuman other ability, and just develop them one by one, and push them all together, eventually somehow become something like human being much better. Or there's another method, and we build up some kind of like a seed AI, some very minimal set of skills that are equipped to allow itself a recursive self-improvement. Which one would be better, like first one or second one? I don't know. Anybody?
Second one,
maybe?
Yeah. Careful with recursive.
So, yeah. Somebody thinks the second one is better, and we kind of think that way. So, when you have to understand, when you do these things, you submit some, I mean, this is for those who are interested in actually participating in our challenge task. Actually, when you're submitting, then you gotta understand the whole point is to allow accelerated learning by reuse of knowledge representation and skills that were learned from previous tasks. So, what are these tasks made of? So, there's this thing called CommAI made by Facebook. So, it's basically that, but a little bit of a change, very tiny little bit. The interaction is not originally based on bit, but we changed it to byte, so it will be easy to represent ASCII character, which is like, you know, basically what it's doing. On top of that, there's a ternary reward signal, minus one, if you do something bad, plus one if you get to something right, and zero if there's nothing to be punished or rewarded upon. And so, how are you gonna do the evaluation on these tasks that we were talking about? There are two kinds of evaluation, qualitative and quantitative. So there's quantitative evaluation that we're doing. It's basically we're saying whoever does this, solve this problem fastest gets the first place. But there is an important aspect of this speed that you need to pay attention. First, is on simulation. So we're measuring the time upon simulation time, the discrete time set. So we are focusing more on data efficiency. Second, there has to be a speed factor so that when you learn some simpler task that has mutual information with harder tasks, you should learn harder tasks faster than you would learn from scratch. That has to be present. No matter how fast it solves anything, everything, if there's no this gradualty of speed up, then we wouldn't accept it as a winning solution. So let me just get to detail what these tasks are at. So these are one of the simple tasks. Task 5.3 in our challenge document. You can just go there and get started, download it. It's available. So input you see is zero and agent is observing reward and input and output also. It can only interact the environment with some kind of output. And okay, it's gonna output nothing. Nothing happens. Maybe it's okay. So it observed dot. Still doesn't happen anything. Not sure what to do. You net a reward. Well, okay, it's not doing anything. No punishment. And so, because we got negative reward only here, so maybe we should write something when that appears. So write up to something, random. Oh, okay, negative reward. But you guess it right eventually. Two, you get positive. Now you have the history of all this input and realize what comes after this one dot when you output it. You got the reward. So when you predict what comes next, maybe you did it. So every time there's zero, three came. So when zero came, let's try if three is correct. Well, it gets it. So now it goes there again to reaffirming, and it gets it. So here's the point here. We start out with blind reinforcement learning, which is only information an agent gets from the environment is to know whether it's doing good or bad. It's only a weird signal channel, nothing else. But eventually, it gets to focus on what comes next, how to predict it. Now, it moved on to supervised learning, which is much more easier to solve than this general R problem in this environment. So, next task, we'll go right here. We still keep the same structure. Output has to come after dot. What you have learned from previous tasks, it has to be reused. I mean, it will be helpful to speed up learning. And somehow gets it right, it gets positive reward. If it doesn't get it right, negative reward. But not only positive and negative reward, but it also has some response from the input field telling the agent what's good or bad. So over time, it should be able to pick up the relationship between some part of the input field that says good job with positive reward and wrong with negative reward. And it also kind of learns using semicolon, tasks are separated. So then, next task comes along. It says all, it keeps all this previous format. Something comes, dot comes, you predict something. Then you get it right, say good job, get it wrong, get negative reward, wrong. So as you see, our mini tasks and micro tasks are designed in a way that reusing previous skills and knowledge representation from easier tasks will be advantageous for learning new tasks deliberately. And when we evaluate, it's gonna be not in exactly the same kind of task that we suggested you to take as an example of the training set, because it'll be just overfitting agent could perform much better. We're gonna test more on generalization capability. So it'll be similar tasks, but not exactly the same. So here's a video. And it's will give you some idea of what it looks like. But you can't really see it though, huh? So when you run it, this is what's gonna look like. Input comes. Yeah, can you see it? And that's the vaccine. In case you couldn't see, I blew it up to show you the previous three slides. You could check them out in the our challenge document in challenge website. We detail how to receive it all, and then yeah. Basically this is what it looks like and what it does, I've already explained. So it's